The word graphic originally comes from the Greek word graphikos, meaning drawn, written or engraved. The oldest graphical expressions found are cave paintings and markings on boulders, antlers and bone. The horse was painted at the hunting route in France thousands of years ago. As society became more complex, the need for keeping records for inventory and accounting purposes grew. Limestone kish tablets with pictographic writing may be the earliest known writing, 3,500 years BC. The Egyptians are the first known to use papyrus instead of parchment, or animal skin, as a writing surface. Papyrus was made from the pith of the papyrus plant and is similar to thick paper. A scroll is a roll of papyrus or parchment and had a length of 10 meters or more. Because ink would slowly flake off of scrolls, text had to be rewritten after some time. Between the 2nd and 3rd centuries, the scroll was replaced by the book. The book made it possible to quickly access a precise point in the text. Most manuscripts were ruled with horizontal lines. But with scribes alone, books could only be produced for a very small amount of people, so text couldn't be made accessible to the public. Around 1300, block printing became the first form of printing in Europe. With block printing, images are printed by placing a piece of paper on a carved and inked wooden block. So block printing was faster, but still far from ideal for text. The breakthrough came in 1450, when goldsmith Johannes Gutenberg started to work with metal type. Individual metal letters were now used to create the text. Gutenberg's first publication was a full-length Bible in 1456. Ambitious publications could have page layouts as elaborate as a modern magazine. With the emergence of newspapers in the 18th century, it became clear that the hand-operated press was much too slow. The first steam-powered press was invented in 1814, but for mass production it was still much too slow. The breakthrough was the transition from flat printing to rotary printing, where the flat printing surface is curved around a cylinder. Rotary printing was first used in 1853, feeding the printer with long rolls of paper instead of single sheets. Printing speed increased to 30,000 prints per hour. High-speed printing dropped the printing costs dramatically, allowing newspapers to become more widespread. It became possible to produce large daily newspaper editions. Printing speed now walked ahead of the slow, labor-intensive typesetting, one letter at a time by hand. So a new way to set type had to be found. Because typing proved to be much faster than placing letters by hand, in 1886 the linotype started to be used by the New York Tribune. The operators would type text from sheets of paper. The machine would automatically produce complete lines of metal type, one line after another, that would then be used for printing. The linotype gave the production of books, magazines and newspapers a big boost, because type could now be set with the speed of typing. Improvements didn't stop, however. In 1949, the photographic revolution started, called photo typesetting. After keyboard input, light was projected through a character, which was projected onto photographic paper. After developing, a strip of photographic paper with text lines would be cut up with a knife in columns of text. The text pieces were glued on the page with wax. Wax was used so the pieces could easily be taken off the page again and be repositioned. When a page was finished, it was photographed again with a large camera that produced a negative as big as the page itself. Then the negative is used to make the printing plate. UV light is projected on the negative. Where UV light passes the negative, the printing plate will harden. Unhardened coating is washed away, leaving the printing surface. The flexible printing plate is then curved around the printing cylinder. The way to transport text from one place to another was by typing text on a machine called a perforator. It was the first digital storage of text, because the text would here be described in just zeros and ones. This was represented on the paper by a hole or no hole in the paper tape. A combination would describe a letter. Punched paper was also the first way to communicate with the first computers. Here we see the IBM 704 from 1957. For both input and output, punched paper cards were used. In the early days, computers had so little memory that magnetic tape had to be used to store data. But retrieving data from these long tapes was a very slow process. For this reason, in 1962, IBM invented the hard disk that was able to give information almost instantly. In 1966, the first computer-driven digital typesetters appeared. They had a simple monochrome screen on which lines of text that were typed were shown. It was now possible to read and correct the text on a screen before it went to output. Fonts had now become digital and were sold on a floppy disk. But these first bitmap fonts would only be a collection of simple dots. Although digital, these fonts couldn't yet be scaled. For each font size, a complete separate image set had to be available. Finished text would now be projected onto photographic paper by a cathode ray tube. Although type had now become digital, page layout was still done by paste-up artists. And to be able to print, still a complicated chemical process was needed. This all changed in the 1980s with the rise of the personal computer and laser printer. Here we see the Macintosh 2 and the Apple LaserWriter. In 1985, the first desktop publishing program PageMaker was released. For the first time, page layout could now be done completely digital, and the result could be printed directly on a laser printer.